mash method is good than the sweet mash method. Okay. So after the fermentation is done, what we get? We now get alcohol, a particular percentage, plus water, which is also present in particular amount. Now usually the alcohol we get is very less in this case. Okay, now what we need to produce? We need to produce a very high quality spirit, which will almost contain 70 to 80% of the spirit, right? So what we can do, we take this wash, and it is transferred into wash region, and we heat them into 80 degrees Celsius. So as we are heating them into 80 degrees Celsius, I remind you that this alcohol is having the boiling temperature of almost 74 or 76 degrees Celsius temperature. So if we heat them in 80 degrees Celsius temperature, alcohol starts to evaporate, and then what we do, we store this alcohol, right? So here you can see the copper tons, right? So copper tunnel like that, simply resembling the cartoon picture that you've seen previously, right? So here it is the controlling segment and the copper tun. Now usually this step is done in copper tun, not in the steel containers. The logic for that is that this copper may act as enzymatic reaction or enzyme cofactors during the process. So it can also help them to provide some more effect of fermentation and also the quality of wine spirit increases. Okay, so for that reason we usually take copper. Now the shape of these tanks are very important, as I have already discussed about it, that as the alcohol is going towards the top direction, it is kind of getting cooled and kind of condensed, so that we can collect it in the in chambers. You can see here it is attached to chambers, we can directly collect it in the chambers. And once we get this alcohol after first distillation, we call those as low wines. Okay, and we require further rounds of distillation there. Okay, so what we can see here, so as the mixture of alcohol and water is a kind of azeotropic mixture, and in this case the temperature or the boiling temperature of alcohol is 78. I was mistaken, I told 74 or 76, actually it is 78 degrees Celsius temperature. So as we are heating the whole mixture is at 80 degrees Celsius, first the alcohol is kind of evaporated, and then they are condensed and stored, then the waters are evaporated. So we won't allow the water to evaporate, because before that for water to evaporate, it requires almost 100 degrees Celsius and more than 100 degrees Celsius temperature. But we are actually heating them in 80 degrees Celsius temperature. That allows us to separate alcohol from the water, and that's the process called the distillation, right? Now if it contains more than 95% of alcohol, it will have no flavor, because no sugars will be remained. Now after the fermentation is done, now that's another very important concept, that when we need to stop the fermentation, that means we are having sugar in and fermentation is going on and alcohol is producing alcohol. Now if we allow this all the sugars that are present to be fermented into alcohol, we don't have any sweetness in our alcohol, right? Because everything is converted to the alcohol and no sugars left. Now usually there are some other materials like sugar and water and mixture of alcohol, and those other materials except for the alcohols are called as congeners. That means sugar, excess sugar and water, right? Now if we require more concentrated alcohol, like 95 and above 90% of 95% of alcohol, in those cases, we may need to convert all the sugars into alcohol. Otherwise, we won't get that high concentration, right? So, if we are converting all the sugars into alcohol, we are end up with no congeners there, only alcohols. Now, in those cases, that kind of product is termed as grain neutral spirit. That means it is not having any trace of grain there. Simple spirit. But this high concentration of, or this high percentage of alcohol is not taken as for consumption. It is injurious for health. So usually this kind of things are taken for the spirit to burn and all these purposes. Okay. Now let us talk about the seventh stage, and that is the maturation. Now Scotch spirit is stored in the matured in oak tusk, usually wooden barrels, as you can see, beautiful looking wooden barrels, and they are put there in usually in the dark and moisture chamber, dark and wet regions, so that wet, dark and cool regions, so they absorb the water and become less alcoholic. That's the reason to store them in the dark region. But usually the usual Scotch whiskey require at least 3 years for this aging. Then we take this Scotch out and then they sell them. Okay, now during this processing, this oak barrels add some extra flavor to the whiskey, and the actual coloration, that's very important. The coloration that we observe, the color of this golden yellow or the color of dark yellow or brown achieved during this time of aging. Okay.